We discussed about sexual reproduction in plants. In sexual reproduction, there are different types of events. For example, first one, gametogenesis. Second one is pollination. Third one, fertilization process. These three events of sexual reproduction completed. Okay, now last one, post-fertilization event. You know very well that in post-fertilization event, actually, what happened? Ovary become fruit. Ovary become fruit. Next to ovum become seed. Understanding, observe here, like this. Next to different organ. Okay. For example, stalk of the flower. Okay, stalk of the flower means pedicel. Pedicel become stalk of the fruit. Understanding? That is different types of events. Next to remaining, calyx, corolla. Okay, calyx, corolla, andricium. And pistil. Okay, pistil means in pistil, stigma. Then another one, style, it all are degenerated. Okay, only here, ovary becomes enlarged and it is developed into the fruit. Next, ovary. Here, after development or after fertilization process, these ovules are involved in division, okay, and in development. Then ultimately, ovules are developed into seed. That is the different types of modification. Okay, post fertilization modification. Very important are these two. Very important modifications are these two. Ovary, fruit. Ovules, seeds. Understanding? Next, let us see one activity. Activity. What is the aim of this activity? To observe pollen grind. This is an activity here. What is? To observe pollen grind. Next, procedure. To observe pollen grind, we have to follow one procedure. Okay, let us study that procedure. First, we have to collect any one flower. Okay, for example, hibiscus flower or tridax flower or any other marigold. Okay, any other flower. For this activity, we have to collect a flower. Then we have to separate the male reproductive part stamens. Male reproductive part stamens. Okay, for example, here like we have to separate stamens. Then we have to take a slide. Like this. Next, we have to pour few drops of water. What? few drops of water on center or the center of the slide or the center of the slide. Then you have to tap. Listen carefully. You have to tap. You have to tap the anchor on the slide. You have to tap the anchor on the slide. When you tap the anchor on the slide, small granule-like structure or grain-like structure fall from the anchor. Fall from the anchor on slide. Fall from the anchor on slide. Like this. Up to here. These are here granule-like structures or grain-like structures. Grain-like structure. Up to here. These grain-like structures, these are the pollen grains. These are pollen grains. These are pollen grains. Are you understanding? Okay, see here. Like this. Now, you have to observe the slide. How to observe the slide under microscope. How to observe the slide under microscope. Are you understanding? When you observe this slide under microscope, you can find out structure of the pollen grain, means external structure. For example, already here, structure of the pollen grain, internal structure it is. Observe, already we discussed about it. This is exine. What? Exine. Here, this black color one is intine. Black color one is intine. Okay, exine, intine. Next, here this thin places, these are usually what? Germophore. Germophore. Next, this is vegetative cell or vegetative cell. Next, here, generative cell. Generating cell. Observe. Vegetative cell. Next one is generative cell. How many cells are present in pollen grain? Actually, two cells. Two cells are present here. How many cells? Two cells. What are they? First one is vegetative cell, second one is generative cell. Okay, are you understanding? Actually, two cells are present like this. In some plant, pollen grind contains three cells. In some plant, understanding, in some plant, maximum 60% of the flowering plant produce pollen grind with two cells. But some plant, 40% of the plant produce pollen grind. Produce pollen grind. Okay, sit here. Three cells. What are these three cells? First one is vegetative cell. Next two. This is one here. Next two. Male gamete. Understanding? Okay, like this, in some pollen grinds, three cells are present. Okay, but actually, in this class, you have to remember only two cells. Okay, there are vegetative cells and generative cells. Understanding? Okay, this is observe here. This is internal structure here. Here, this is nucleus of the vegetative cell, cytoplasm. Next, this is a generative cell, nucleus of the generative cell, like this. Okay, this is our structure. To observe the pollen grind, we have to follow this procedure. Understanding? See, observe all. Actually, pollen grinds are yellow in color. These are yellow in color. When we tap anther on this slide, we can observe yellow color grind like structure. These yellow color grind like structures are pollen grind. This is the structure of the pollen grind. Observe all important points. Okay, next, let us do another activity. To observe germination of pollen grind. Germination of pollen grind. Another important activity is here. First, we have to take slides. Like this. Then, we have to put few drops of water at the center of the slide. Next, we have to tap anthers on the slide. When you tap anthers on the slide, you can observe yellow color grind like structure on the slide. Okay, these are usually pollen grind. That pollen grind. Understanding? Next, you have to take a beaker. You have to take a beaker like this. Then how to prepare the sugar solution? How to prepare sugar solution? By mixing the water and sugar. This is a sugar solution. Next, you have to place few drops of sugar solution. Few drops of sugar solution around the coal and grinds present on the slide. Around the coal and grinds present on the slide. Then you have to leave a slide for 20 to 30 minutes. Okay. After 20 to 30 minutes, you have to observe the slide under microscope. How to observe this light under microscope? When we observe this light under microscope, we can observe germinating, isn't it clear? Germinating and germinated pollen grain. For example, observe, this is hole and tube. Okay. Next here. It is generating cell. Next, you know, here vegetative cell, enzyme, like pollen tube. When we add sugar solution around the pollen grains, what will happen? Due to presence of sugar solution around them, they are germinated. During germination process, what will happen? Internal membrane means in time. Observe this black color one. This in time is extended. By forming a tube-like structure from the through germ pore. In time is extended by forming a tube-like structure. This tube-like structure is called here pollen tube. This is the here pollen germination. Okay, observe all important points. Observe one. Next, let us do another activity. Here, aim is to observe germination of seeds and parts of seeds. This is our aim of this activity. Here, first we have to take seeds. First, we have to take Bengal gram or groundnut seeds. Bengal gram. Then you have to soak them. In water. For overnight. You have to soak them in water for overnight. After night means early morning. You have to collect seeds from beaker. And you have to place this seed in a wet cloth. Next, you have to tightly like this. Then you have to keep this entire wet cloth containing the wet seed for one day. Understanding? For one day. Here, other important part is you have to sprinkle water on this wet cloth. At different intervals. Why means to keep the seed and the cloth wet. We have to sprinkle the water at different intervals. Okay, are you understanding? This is our activity. Then after one day, you have to open the wet cloth and collect the seeds. how to open wet cloth and collect the seed. Next, we have to collect one seed and we have to open the seed. How to open the seed and we have to observe the two pot leaders and entire open the seed by using the hand rein. First, you have to see the open seed by using hand lens. Okay. Then how to observe here? Here, like this structure, observe. When we observe open seed, we can observe, we can find out this type of structure. Here, these are cotyledon. Okay, here, cotyledon 1, 2, means two cotyledon. Bengal gram or any other. Here we take, Bengal gram seed. Understanding, we have taken Bengal gram seed. That is, Bengal gram is, it is dicot. You know very well that dicot. In Bengal gram seed, two cotyledons are present. Observe, this is cotyledon 1, here cotyledon 2. These are two cotyledons. Next, here observe this green color structure. This green color structure is actually embryo. What is it? Embryo. You know, embryo has different types of pods. For example, okay, observe embryo pods. Embryo and embryonic axis, next of cotyledon, listen carefully, embryonic axis, next of cotyledon. These are two important parts present in embryo. Embryonic axis, again, embryonic axis, listen carefully here, has radical nexus other one plumage nectum epicortex nectum hypocortex. These are the main parts in embryonic axis. For example, imagine this embryonic axis. Here, embryonic axis. Imagine next year. These are two cotyledons. Imagine these are two cotyledons. Next, this region. Listen carefully. From here to here, this entire part is epicortex. Epicortex. Next is tip of the epicortex. Tip of the epicortex is plumage. Tip of the epicortex is plumage. Next, here this part. From here to here, entire part is. Okay, entire part is hypocortex. It is hypocortex. Observe. Tip of the hypocortex. This tip. Tip of the hypocortex is radical. Is radical. Are you understanding? Observe carefully. Tip of the hypocortex is radical. Next. Here observe, in this activity, this green color structure is embryo. This green color structure is here what? Actually this is embryo. Here we can observe plumage. Next, radical. During the germination of seed from plumage, from plumage, shoot system is developed. What? Shoot system is developed from plumage during the germination process. Here from radical root system. Root system is developed. Root system is developed. Are you understanding? Okay, observe all these. These are cotyledons here. Two big size particles. Okay, are seed leaf. Cotyledons are also called as seed leaf. Seed leaf. Observe once all. Next, life cycle of flowering plant. Life cycle of flowering plant. Flowering plant. These are also called as phaenogam. These are also called as phaenogam. Here, flowering plant. First, mature plant. Now, mature plant when next pollination. Thank you. pollen grain, transfer of pollen grain means pollination. Means pollination process here. Next, after pollination, again observe fertilization. What? Fertilization process. Fusion of male and female gametes. Fusion of male and female gametes. Means inside of the ovary means embryo shock. Here just fertilization. Fertilization. After fertilization process, you know very well. After fertilization process, zygote is formed. Or zygote. From zygote, embryo next from embryo simple fruit or simple fruit. Next, seed next. Germination of seed. Germination of seed. Next, seedling to be a seedling. Next, mature plants. Now see here, this is our life cycle. Okay, life cycle of flowering plant. Life cycle of flowering plant. Observe all important points. Okay, next, this entire sexual reproduction plant. Okay, sexual reproduction plant, total topic completed. Next, another important one is cell division. What? Cell division. Cell division and continuation of life. Cell division and continuation of life. Observe, what is cell division actually? It's also a very important topic in reproduction chapter. Okay, cell division, continuation of life. To continue the life, to produce the next generation, to improve the, or to develop our body part, to increase the size of body, we need cell division process. We need cell division process. Actually, what is cell division? What is cell division? Observe here, cell division. Division of cell, breaking of cell into two or into four. Understanding? In one type of cell division, cell is broken down into two equal cells, two equal cells. In another type of cell division, one cell is broken down into four equal cells. Like this, in cell division process, cell is divided into two cells or four cells. Why this cell division is important? Without cell division, cell number or number of cells is not increased. For example, zygote. First, after fertilization process in mother womb or implant inside of the ovary, a small zygote is formed. A small zygote is formed. without cell division proper, what will happen? That zygote remains as it is inside of the mother womb or inside of the ovary. Understanding? Then, if there is no cell division process to divide and to form embryo and to form a baby and to form a developed organism, each and every living organism requires cell division. Requires cell division. In this topic, we will discuss about total cell division process, history of the cell division process, different types of discoveries of cell division process, natural types of cell division, cell cycles, like these different types of subtopics are present under the cell division topic. Okay, you know very well that first time Rudolf Virchow, you know, he is a proponent of cell theory. Cell theory was proposed by who? Sladen and Swan. Sladen and Swan. In addition to Sladen and Swan, Rudolf Virchow, another sound proponent of the cell theory, he stated, listen carefully, he stated one important phase that is actually what? Omnicellular, what? Omnicellular, decellular. This is very, very important statement. Omnicellular, decellular means, you know, new cells arise from our new cells. Are new cells come from pre-existing cells? New cells come from pre-existing cells. This is a very, very important statement proposed by Rudolf Virchow. Understanding how new cells arise from pre-existing cells, how many pre-existing cells break and form new cells, Very, very important statement it is. This statement was proposed by Rudolf Virchow. Understanding? Next, other findings. Robert Remark. Okay. What? Who? Robert Remark. In the year 1852. He was the first person to study the cell division. To conduct the experiments on cell division. Robert Remark. He was the first person. In the year 1852, he conducted a number of experiments on embryo. On embryo. Listen carefully. On embryo, he conducted number of experiments. Ultimately, he stated After several experiments on embryos, he stated the binary fission of cells. Listen carefully. Binary fission of cells. What binary fission of cells? What? अच्छे से बाइनरी फिजन ऑफ सेल्स वन मींस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन ऑफ सेल एनिमल सेल ओके दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेटमेंट प्रपोज्ड बाय रॉबर्ट रिमर ओके